For many years, my main programmer for AVR microcontrollers has been AVR Dragon. This can do much more than just programming. It can be used as a debugger, high voltage programmer for fixing misconfigured microcontrollers, and much more. That is far from simple, and I paid more than 50 bucks for it many years ago, and especially at that time, it was a lot of money. I've been happy with it, but now I need something simpler and cheaper, which I could even give to friends so they can update the firmware of some of their AVR-based devices. My first programmer for AVR microcontrollers was just a parallel port cable with few series resistors. I loved the simplicity of that programmer. Making a new one took just a few minutes and didn't cost much more than just a spare cable from junk bin. That was thanks to the versatility of parallel port. The port that doesn't exist in most modern computers, so it's not a relevant option anymore. Solution is my simple circuit and these PCBs from the sponsor of this video, PCBWay.com. Whether you are buying PCBs for your own project or ones shared online, you can order them from PCBWay.com for as low as $5 for 10 pieces of 10 by 10 centimeter PCBs. Here are samples of some, but not all, of the different color options you can choose from. And if your project requires more advanced PCBs, 3D printed parts, or even CNC milled parts, those are available from PCBWay.com as well. For all your prototyping and low volume production needs, go check out PCBWay.com for up-to-date information on their offering. Like I said, I have been happy with the AVR Dragon, but it can be a little bit too big and complicated for simple and quick firmware updates in the field, or for borrowing to friends who had never used it before. I want a modern equivalent to those old parallel port based programming cables, and I believe my CH551G based AVR programmer hardware is just that. This is as simple as it gets. The main part is CH551G microcontroller with built-in USB. It requires decoupling capacitors for 5V and 3.3V pins. Then there's USB-C jack and the two resistors which are required for the PC's USB-C port to recognize this as a device. Now I decided to solder a 6-pin female header on this, so this can be directly plugged into the standard AVR ISP header of the target port. Usually at this point one is wondering, how to get the proper programmer firmware in this microcontroller? Don't I need a programmer to do that? Answer is no. When the firmware hasn't been programmed into the CH551G, it will go to bootloader mode automatically, which allows uploading the firmware over USB. And after the initial programming, the programmed firmware will run instead of the bootloader. Updating the firmware of this programmer can be done by bridging these two pads with solder and connecting the USB-C cable. That will activate the bootloader after the initial flashing. Even though the part count is already quite low, there's one optional component that isn't always required. This resistor is in series with a solder jumper, and this doesn't need to be populated for normal use. At first I started porting the Arduino as ISP, Arduino sketch, by combining it with the USB device CDC example from the SDCC package. I did manage to get this recognized as an AVR programmer, but communication with the target AVR microcontroller wasn't working yet. After a while of testing my circuit and trying to port the firmware, I found this PicoISP project by Stefan Wagner. It has voltage selector for selecting 5V or 3.3V, it has indicator LED and a USB-A plug. This looks like a great general purpose programmer. But even though I want something simpler, and my circuit has some differences to the Stefan's circuit, I should be able to use the code from his project and compile it for my hardware as long as I first change the used pins in the config.h file. But to my surprise, it didn't work either. AVR dude does detect the programmer, but won't communicate with the target chip. After checking the pinout, my wiring, and all the possible places where I could have made a mistake, I decided to test another target. The Arduino compatible port I have used for testing doesn't work properly. I tried a couple of my own projects and another Arduino Uno, and they all work properly. I successfully updated the bootloader on these ports and uploaded a test firmware to this one. Erasing, flashing and verification works properly. Who knows, maybe I was able to port the Arduino's ISP sketch for CH551G chip in the first place, but I deleted the code already so I cannot confirm that. The code from Stefan's project works fine, so there's no need for me to try porting the code again. In Windows 10 I did use program called Jadig to install libusb driver for the USB Tiny ISP, which is the name my programmer shows up as in the device manager. This step may or may not be required depending on your operating system. I'll put the links to the Stefan's GitHub repo in the description. See you next video. Thanks.